As a seasoned cruiser and contributor on the Cruiser's Edge, I thought I had seen it all when it came to navigating the high seas and bustling ports of call. After years of experience, countless voyages, and meticulous research, I considered myself well-equipped to avoid the pitfalls that sometimes await unsuspecting travelers. Little did I know that even a seasoned traveler like myself could fall prey to a scam in the enchanting Caribbean. I got scammed. It was my own fault. I got caught in FOMO, fear of missing out. It's a real thing, so I want to share my experience with you guys so you won't fall victim to the same thing on any of your cruises. Our goal here at the Cruise's Edge is to tap into our decades of cruise experience and share what we've learned over the years to help improve your cruise experiences. And that's why I wanted to share my personal experience on this cruise. So the story begins with us stopping at a port I've been to several times. We've always enjoyed this port, and we're glad to spend the day there again. Just like in past visits, our cruise was going smoothly, enjoying all the joys of the cruising experience I had grown to love. Yet, it was during this port visit that I would encounter a situation that would make me question my own judgment. I'm normally not a big shopper when I travel to many of the ports we visit. I mostly spend time enjoying the pools and beaches. I would say I usually focus more on the relaxation aspect of cruising more than I do on shopping or even sightseeing for that matter. There's so many exciting and fun things to do on a cruise with the shows, parties, clubs, and casinos, not to mention the beautiful destinations. But sometimes for me, there's nothing better than getting a good book and sitting by the pool and just unplugging for a while. If you can find an area that's not too crowded, many of the cruise lines now have adults-only areas, and you can usually find a relaxing spot. Carnival has what they call the Serenity Deck. Royal Caribbean has the Solarium. And the entire ship is adults only on Virgin Voyages, but I'm not sure there are too many really quiet times on there. We've put together a video on cruise lines and which ones to avoid as well as which ones might be for you. I'll be sure to put a link in the description so that you can watch that one next. Be sure to subscribe and ring the notification bell to be notified of our upcoming videos so you won't miss out. Anyway, on this particular trip, I had a particular piece of jewelry in mind, and I had done my homework. I knew exactly what a reasonable price should be, and I was determined not to be taken advantage of. Armed with this knowledge, I embarked on my shopping quest, ready to strike a bargain that would leave me satisfied. However, as fate would have it, the first store I entered couldn't quite meet my price expectations. Just as I was about to turn and leave, something else caught my eye, an item that seemed irresistible. The owner, sensing my interest, approached and made me an offer that seemed almost too good to be true. I myself come from a sales background and I know how the process works and I know the pitfalls that potentially exist in every sales transaction for the buyer. Let us know in the comments section, have you all ever been scammed or fallen prey to what you felt was an unscrupulous sales transaction on any of your cruise vacations or on any vacation? We'd love to hear from you.
Hey guys, the sail away party is about to begin. This is Shay, your cruise director. Everyone's finished their muster drill and now the fun's about to get kicked off. But first the captain's at it again. Gotta get things tidied up first. There are a lot of cruise enthusiasts looking for this kind of information. A lot of research and effort goes into making a video like this, so we're swabbing the deck. If you guys can get busy polishing up that like button, it would be a great help to us. And maybe we can beat that algorithm monster. And they'll be able to find us before the sail away party begins. If you don't want to miss out on the fun, take some time with that subscribe button, and you'll be invited to join us. Okay, guys, this is Shay signing off. Back to the video.
In a situation where my instinct should have been to verify the price online or consult my smartphone for comparison, I found myself uncharacteristically without my trusty device. This lapse in judgment left me in a vulnerable position, and I knew it. But I was still unsure about the purchase. In a moment of indecision, I decided to test the waters by making a low-ball offer, thinking there was no way it would be accepted. To my astonishment, the owner agreed without hesitation. That should have been my red flag, but I felt oddly compelled to buy the item at that moment. The allure of the discount was too tempting to resist. He assured me that the list price is comparable to what you'd find elsewhere. I made the purchase, convinced that I had scored an incredible deal. However, it was only after returning to the cruise ship and conducting some online research that I realized the harsh truth. I had overpaid significantly for the item. It was a bitter pill to swallow, especially for someone who prided themselves on being a savvy traveler. There are so many places where you will find very high list prices on items that just aren't worth what they're asking. And they use that high initial price to catch people off guard and give themselves plenty of room to make a really overinflated profit on an item. Some might say that's not a scam, but I feel like it shows just a bit of dishonesty up front. I don't mind anyone making a profit, and it's not up to me to decide what that profit margin should be. But the way I always approached sales in my past was, when I sold something, I wanted to make sure the buyer received a fair deal and felt good about their purchase. That may sound a little Pollyannish, but that's just me. Anyway, the lesson I learned from this experience was crystal clear. No matter how seasoned a traveler you are, always trust your instincts and never make impulsive decisions, especially in a new and unfamiliar environment, or even in this case, in an environment that you've come to know over time. It's easy to let the allure of a bargain cloud your judgment, but taking a step back to assess the situation objectively can save you from potential scams. I've been asked to share which port this occurred, but I don't really feel it's necessary because what happened to me is not port exclusive. It could have happened in any one of the ports we've visited. It also could happen in my hometown, for that matter. In sharing this story on the Cruiser's Edge, my aim is to emphasize the importance of staying vigilant and making informed decisions while traveling. And I say while traveling because when we're traveling, we're seeking that opportunity to unwind, let our hair down, and just have fun. And sometimes when letting our hair down, we also let our guard go down as well. No one is immune to scams, and even the most experienced travelers can be taken off guard. It's a lesson that I'll carry with me on all my future adventures, and I hope it serves as a valuable reminder to all of our subscribers as well. To always stay cautious and learn from our mistakes, no matter how seasoned we may be. Thanks for watching The Cruiser's Edge. Our goal is to help keep you informed and up to date on all things cruising, giving you an edge on cruising. If there's a video topic you'd like for us to cover, be sure to let us know in the comments section. So until next time, guys, relax, have a great time, enjoy your vacations, and always keep the tips from Cruiser's Edge in mind. Happy cruising!